Alright, so now I hate to get it rudimentary that word, but I'm not going. There is a singing at this church now since the communion wafer deal, and my truth with it, I'm not really Catholic, so I'm not going. I'm not going to any of these get-togethers, and so it's gonna be strange because they seem to be highly religious here. I'm not really sure how to deal with this much religion. All of a sudden, they just do it. I tried, you know. I immersed into what they are doing in their life, and it's not. It's not. It was not really a place for me to be anyway. I guess you could say so. I'm practically sacrilegious, you know, by the meanderings in my mind. It's definitely not a church for me to go to attend. So I guess I stay away, and they can now sing in their beautiful light, lofty frolics there, and congratulations to their direction, I guess so. So I almost now feel like I have been there as a spy, and so I've been to church. I know what they're doing there, and so I do feel as a spy. Perhaps they should not have let me in. I don't know. Maybe they needed to do some kind of like a, what do we call it? Some kind of a test at the beginning, entrance or whatever, or some rumor roll. Do we have a rumor roll? You know, if we have the roll, a rumor roll about this person or that person, and then we just don't even let them even go into the church, even open or pry that book open for a moment. And go through the little leaflets of what they're going to sing next, you know. I was really only going specifically for the singing, so in reality I was using them. Yeah, gosh, it gets heavy. It's heavy there, you know. It gets very heavy. It's shocking heavy. It's a shocking heavy, I just can't believe. Wow. So in a way, I'm gleeful that I'm not going. I'm not playing hooky though. I'm not feeling. However, they do have the tendency, you know, when they are in the group mentality that they are those, they do have the tendency to push that you're playing hooky at. You know, like this. It's like bizarre, very bizarre. And yeah, so it's all about this God deal, and it's just the way they practice how they believe in this God, and that's their version. And it is a very strange organization that has even lasted this long, and the people keep plunking into it, you know, day in and day out, or weekly, or whatever. It's very strange. I'm still not understanding it, but in a way, like I said, you know, if it keeps if it keeps them from less fighting and less killing each other, then maybe it's good. I'll give it that. I'll give it that. But in reality, it's really old. It's really old and staid. So when it's staid, it's staid. And when it is this, it's just passé, and it's just not gonna work. I really don't believe it's going to work. Yeah, it has not reached an expansionism in the person's mind, you know. It hasn't taken them to places other, you know, places where we're like, well, where is the calm out of my life experience? Am I getting that actual answer? You know, what am I looking for? I need something past this. And no, I don't want to be a guru actually talking in their church either. So I don't think I can actually reach that group of people. No, I find them extremely defensive and clummy. When you're defensive and clummy, you're just fighting a brain that is just lives in a barbed wire world with its electrocom, and there's no way you're gonna get through it. So no, I decline any speaking at that particular church or others. If you are curious, I'm not going to be a speaker. So I'll turn that off, that direction. Yeah, I don't know. It's just, you know, there's just been way too much community organization in that direction, and I'm not actually finding a peace on this earth. It's just like only when the people are singing, and No, that's not the direction for peace on earth. You want peace on earth, you fight it now with politics. It's not you there. And you know, if you're not a spiritual person, you can't go there and have God fight it for you and go, oh, please, please, trust and believe, la la la, and the God. He's not gonna make the peace on the earth. I disagree with all of this. Yeah, it's that's the problem here when we're talking a philosophy, when we're dealing with the philosophic state. Yes, trying to get through and try to explain, you know, what it is. And it's like, well, no, it's not another recipe for a pizza. You know, it's not that simple. It's not that simple. You can't just say, well, let's just add another topping and then you are understanding philosophy of yourself. It's something I don't even want to express today, actually. Yeah. You know, there's so much negative. There's so much negative that I'm just like, well, how do I get through all of the negative in people's minds first? You know, they have all of these walls and all of these negatives, and it's like, and many times these negatives and these walls are built by these colostomies of religion. You know, they're just built by them, and just terrible. So I'm not sure how they get through there. I'm not sure how they get through all of this barrage of it. Eventually, you know, they even find your own self. How do you find your own self from this group? How do you get out of that barbed wire electrocution moment? That's where you live in that type of safety, because you say you claim yourself as Catholic, or you say you claim yourself as Mormon, or you say you claim yourself as Presbyterian, or a Baptist, or a Methodist, or it goes on and on. You know, yeah, you're stuck, you're in there, and there is some odd, weird, strange, like, I guess you're friends with the persons that you share that experience. And everything else out is negative, and it's almost like, yeah, my grandmother, well, she was just like anybody who wasn't a Mormon, could just, like, you know, really was just a worthless human. She was just this way. She just did not believe the others had any value until they actually entered the church. Any of us that were out of the church and not doing the church's deeds and wonders were completely worthless. So yeah, I mean, just face it, they're absolutely the most judgmental persons ever. Doesn't matter, you can say Catholic Church, you can say Mormon Church, you can say Jewish or with a synagogue, they are the most judgmental at the other people. And I don't know, I don't know, I'm just not, I'm not really enjoying that this is how people are staying under their guise of something called God and something called family, and has to be brought up in a good life, a good situation, and how that is a health and well-being state. I don't believe that's a health and well-being state. I think it's barbaric in a way, that because there is that castation that exists on the other side of the fence constantly. The castigation of the others, you know. Yeah, so yeah. So it's not really helping anything. It's not helping philosophy. It's not helping any of the we call them any of the more natural thought thinking directions of spirituality. You know, freedom of the self. You know, you look at your freedom of the self. You know, what was free today? You know, what was free today in your surroundings? You know, did you have rain falling free? You know, did you notice that as a freedom of yourself? Did you notice that freedom? You know, Was that something synonymous with you? You know, was that the tear eyes of you? Was that the tears of your own pains, your own agonies falling from the sky, your own disheartens, your own sadnesses, your own congestions. Yeah, it's looking at the world and you as a bond together. You and the world as a bond together, as you know, you are the rain also.